Dear students, today let us discuss about curl fitting, which is module 4. So it is a method of finding the specific relation connecting the dependent and independent variables for a given data. So dependent variable means it is y, independent variable means it is x. So here in curl fitting we are having three types. First one is fitting of a straight line, which is of the form y equal to ax plus b. For this, we are going to write the normal equations. So just first you apply the summation for this equation. Summation of y equal to a as it is, summation of x into n into b. B, a and b are constants. So here b you have to write as it is, but it has to be multiplied by n. So n into b. Next, for this equation, you have to just multiply by x. So summation of x into y equal to a as it is, x into x will become summation of x square plus b as it is, it has to be multiplied by summation of x. So these are the normal equations for a straight line. Second type is fitting of a second degree parabola y equal to ax square plus bx plus c. So for this also we are going to write the normal equations. So normal equations are given by, first step you have to apply just summation. So summation of y equal to a into summation of x square plus b into summation of x plus c is constant but it has to be multiplied by n. Second equation, just multiply by x for this equation. So summation of x into y is equal to a into summation of x square into x, x cube, b into summation of x, it is when you multiply by x it will become x square, plus c is constant. When you multiply by summation of x, it will be summation of x. Next step, again for this equation, you have to multiply by x. So, it will be summation of x square y is equal to a into summation of x cube into x is, summation of x is to 4, plus b as it is, summation of x square into x is, summation of x cube, plus c as it is, summation of x, when you multiply by x again, it will become summation of x square. So these three are the normal equations for a second degree parabola. Now third one, fitting of a curve of the form y equal to a into x plus b. For this, we are going to write the normal equations here. So our curve is here, y equal to ax plus b. Just apply log both the sides. So log y to the base e is equal to log a to the base e plus b into log of x to the base e. When you apply logarithm on both the sides, then log y to the base e, if I denote it as capital Y, and log a to the base e, if I denote it as y, capital A, plus this b as it is, log x to the base e, if I call it as a capital X, then this equation, as you are observing, y equal to a plus bx, which is again a straight line form. So we know how to write the normal equations in straight line form. So first step for this equation, just multiply by summation. So summation of y equal to n into a plus b as it is, summation of x. Second step, you have to multiply by capital X here, because we have taken here it is capital X. So multiply by capital X here. Summation of xy is equal to a into summation of x plus b as it is, x into x it will become summation of x square. So these are the normal equations here. Means this curve has been converted to a straight line form. Then you are writing the normal equations. So what is capital Y here? Capital Y is nothing but a log y to the base e. What is capital A? Log a to the base e. Whereas small a is equal to e raised to a, capital A. Capital X is log x to the base e. So here we need to calculate a and b values. And here in second degree parabola equation we need to calculate a, b, c values. And in straight line form, again here we are going to calculate a and b values. So let us discuss the examples on the first one, straight line form. So by the method of least square, find the straight line that fits the following data. So the values of x has been given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The values of y are 14, 27, 40, 55, 68. So, this is a straight line form. Y equal to x plus v. First, we will write the normal equations. So, summation of y equal to a into summation of x plus n into v. And summation of second equation, when you multiply by x, you will get summation of xy equal to a into summation of x square plus b into summation of x. So, these are the normal equations. Now, according to normal equations, you have to prepare the table or columns you have to prepare here. So, you need the value of summation of y. So, y column is here, y is given here, the values of x are given here. And you need summation of y value. So, summation of y, 204. You need summation of x value. So, when you add these all values, you will get summation of x as 15. Then, you need summation of xy. So, x into y means you have to multiply here. All 14 into 1, 14. 2 into 27, 54. 3 into 40, 120. 4 into 55, 220. 5 into 68, 340. So, when you add all these values, you will get summation of xy as 748. Then you need the value of summation of x square. So, x square column is here. So, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25. So, its summation value is 55. When you add all these values, you will get 55. So, you calculated all these values. Now, substitute these values in normal equations. Substitute in normal equations. So, here see, summation of y. Summation of y means its value is 204. So, 204 equal to a into summation of x. Summation of x value is 15a plus n into b. N is here 5 because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 total 5 values are there. So, n value is 5. So, 5 into b. Now, coming to the second equation. Summation of xy. Summation of xy means it is 748. So, 748 is equal to a into summation of x square. Summation of x square value is 55. So, 55 into a plus b into summation of x. Summation of x value is 15. So, 15 into b. So, when you solve these two equations, when you solve these two equations by using the calculator, you will get the values of a and b. So, a is here 13.6, b is here 0. So, these two values, again back in the straight line form equation, have to substitute. So, a value is here 13.6. So, y equal to 13.6 into x plus b value is 0. So, we have not written. So, this is the last answer. Y equal to 13.6 into x. So, whatever the values you will calculate, a and b values, at the end you have to substitute in that equation form. Okay, let us discuss the second example now. Fit a least square straight line y equal to ax plus b for the following data. So, again the x values are being given. X values are minus 5, minus 3, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 4. The values of pi are 0.4, 0.1, minus 0.2, 0.3, minus 0.3, 0.1 and 0.4. Okay, so this is the straight line form equation. First, we have to write the normal equations. So, just apply the summation here. Summation of pi equal to a into summation of x plus n into b. Then multiply by x. So, summation of x pi plus a into summation of x square plus b is constant, summation of x. So, what is the value of n here? Total number of values here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, n value is here 7. So, according to normal equations, you have to prepare the table, prepare the columns here. So, you need summation of y, you need summation of x, you need summation of x bar, you need summation of x square, so, and summation of x. So, all these values are to calculate here. X values has been given. We have calculated the summation of x value. as minus 2. Y values has been given. We calculated the summation of y value, which is 0.8. XY, so just multiply here, minus 5 to 0.4, minus 2, minus 3 into 0.1, minus 0.3, so on. So its summation value, summation of XY value is minus 0.6. Then X square value, minus 5 whole square 25, minus 3 square 9, 1, it is 0, again 1, 2 square is 4, and 4 square is 16. So when you add all these values, we get summation of X square as 56. So substitute all these values in the normal equations. Substitute in the normal equations. So summation of Y. Summation of Y means 0.8. 0.8 equal to summation of X. Summation of X is minus 2. Minus 2 into A. Plus L value is 7 here. So 7 into B. Then next equation is summation of XY. Summation of XY value is minus 0.6 is equal to A into summation of X square. X square summation of X square value is 56. So 56 into A plus B into summation of X. Summation of X value is again here minus 2. So minus 2. So when we solve these two equations using calculator, we get A value as minus 0.0067 and B as 0.112. So substitute these A and B values in this equation form, Y equal to AX plus B is there, no? There you have to substitute. So Y equal to A value is minus 0.0067, A plus B value is 0.112. Thank you.